Good morning, children. We are going to begin session 2 today. I am going to continue from where I left in the previous session. I am teaching class 12, ISC English Literature, Tempest, Act 4, Scene 1. Please open your books on page 64. I was on line number 25. I would like to give a brief recollection of the two speeches which I taught before. Please pay attention, children. Prospero tells Ferdinand that he is ready to give his daughter Miranda to Ferdinand to marry her, as he has passed the test which Prospero had set for him. He warns him not to dishonor her maidenhood before the holy ceremony of marriage. He tells him that if he does that, then even the gods will not bless this marriage contract. I had explained till here. Now I am going to continue from here. What Ferdinand replies, please pay attention. Line number 25. Ferdinand says, "As I hope for quiet days, fair issue and long life, with such love as 'tis now the murkiest den, the most opportune place, the strongest suggestion or worser genius can, shalt never melt mine honor into lust to take away the edge of that day's celebration." So Ferdinand says, as I hope for quieter days, he wants to have peaceful days, quieter days, peaceful days, fair issue. Fair issue means good children or fine children. He wants to have fine children and long life. And he says, with such love as it is now, and the same love that exists now, the murkiest den, even the murkiest den. The murkiest den means even the darkest den, the darkly secluded clay cave, or the most opportune place. Opportune place, most favorable opportunity, even the most favorable opportunity, or the strongest suggestions. Strongest suggestions, temptations. Suggestion means temptations. Even these cannot spoil his marriage. Our worser genius can, shall never melt mine honor into lust. Worser genius means evil spirit. Even the evil spirit can means knows. Even the evil spirit knows that my desires shall never melt mine honor. That is, I shall not, nothing will tempt me to spoil my honor with lust. Even the darkest den, even the favorable opportunity, the strongest temptation or prompting of my evil spirits, evil genius cannot take away the edge of that day celebration. Edge here, sharpness. The sharpness of that day celebration. Day celebration refers here to the marriage ceremony. So he says, I shall not dull the keen delight of the ceremony on the day of my marriage. He further says, when I shall think our Phoebus steeds are foundered or night kept chained below. Foundered means collapsed. Collapsed. So Ferdinand says, he will think that the wedding night will never come, either because the horses drawing the sun's chariot. Phoebus here means sons, and steeds here means horses. The Phoebus, horses of the sun god. Phoebus steeds, horses of the sun god. He says, because the horses drawing the sun's chariots have collapsed through overwork, or because the night is forcibly prevented from coming, for another expression of such impatience. Because it is a night kept chained below. Night has been personified in this line, children. To that Prospero says, fairly spoke, sit then and talk with her, she is thine own. He gets assured, Prospero gets assured, and he says that, alright, Now you sit down and talk with Miranda. She is now yours. What, Ariel? What? He is summoning, he is calling Ariel. He says, what here means come here. What? Come here. He is calling Ariel. And then he says, my industrious servant Ariel. Industrious, hardworking. Hardworking servant Ariel. He is calling Ariel. Enter Ariel. Ariel. What would my potent master, here I am. What does my powerful master, strong master, potent means strong or powerful. What does my strong master desire now? I am here. Prospero says, thou and thy meaner fellows, your last service did worthily perform. You and your followers, your junior spirits, have done the job, last job, very well. And I must use you in such another trick. He says, another trick here means another task. He says, I have to use you on another task. He gives him the task. He says, go bring the rabble. Rabble means crowd or mob. He says, go and bring the crowd over whom I give thee power here to this place, incite them to quick motion. He says, incite them to quick motion, provoke them. Incite means to provoke. Rabble means crowd. Motion means performance. Motion, performance. And he says that, I am giving you power, I am giving you control to this place, and bring them quickly for action, for I want to show this couple. He says, bestow upon the eyes of this young couple some vanity of my art. Vanity of my art. Vanity here means illusion. Illusion created by my magic art. It is my promise and they expect it from me. He further says, I have promised them and they expect it. They expect that I show some magic. Ariel says, presently. Presently means immediately. Do you want this to be done immediately? Prospero says, A, with a twink. A means yes. With a twink, with a twinkling of an eye. Ariel says, before you can say come and go and breathe twice and cry so, each one tripping on his toe will be here with mop and mow. Do you love me, master? No. Tripping. Tripping means dancing. Ariel says, even before you can say come and go and breathe twice and cry so, they will be here. These people, these spirits will be here. Each spirit will be dancing on his tiptoe. With grins and grimaces. Mop and mow means grim and grimaces or pulling funny faces. Or pulling funny faces. Then he says, he asks him a question. He says, do you love me, master? And he even replies, no. Prospero says, dearly, my delicate Ariel, I love you dearly. Do not approach till thou dost hear me call. Don't come till I hear you. Till I call you. Do not appear until you hear me call you. Ariel says, well, I conceive. Conceive means understand. I can understand what you say. Prospero says to Ferdinand, look, thou be true. Do not give dalliance too much the rein. Dalliance too much the rein means here too freely to amorous spirits. The strongest oaths are straw. The strongest oaths here means the strongest vows. To the fire, the blood. To the fire, the blood means flame of passion. Be more abstemious or else good night your vow. He tells him, have a greater control on yourself or else farewell to your vow. Actually, abstemious also means not allowing to have much food. He's telling him not to have much food. For to that, Ferdinand replies, I warrant you, sir, I give you warranty, I assure you, the white cold virgin snow upon my heart abates the ardor of my liver. He says, he assures him and he says, I assure you, sir, the maidenly chastity Abates here means diminishes. Ardor means intensity of my liver. I assure you, the maidenly chastity of my soul will keep the flame of passion and love low. He actually means to say, my love is utterly pure that it even calls my desires, which was then thought, my love is utterly pure that it even cools my desires, which was then thought to rise from the liver. Because we understand that desires come from the heart, not from the liver. Today, in those times, it used to come from the liver. To that, Prosper replies, well, now, come my ill, bring a corollary, rather than want a spirit. Appear and pertly, no tongue all eyes, be silent. Prospero says, well, now come my Ariel, bring a corollary. Corollary means to bring a few more spirits, rather than want a spirit, rather than lack of some one spirit. He says, bring a few more spirits than are strictly needed. Appear and pertly. Pertly means smartly. He says, let them appear smartly. And he also says, no tongue, all eyes. I want them all not to say anything, but to be attentive and be quiet. Soft music, please. This session comes to an end here. We'll continue the next session. Till then, I want to give you some home assignment, children. Please attempt the extract questions given in your workbook, Act 4, Scene 1. Attempt those questions of the speeches which I have taught you. Till then, I end the session here.